In the previous video, we discussed some basics of the audiogram and how to assess the degree of hearing loss. In this video, we will discuss the type of hearing loss, which may be conductive, sensorineural or mixed. Conductive hearing loss ko assess karne ke liye audiogram pe do conditions jo hain wo fulfill honi chahiye. Number one, there should be airborne gap, and number two is bone conduction should be normal. As you can see in the blue graph, bone conduction and air conduction, there is some difference of almost 40 decibels, and bone conduction is in the normal range, which is above the 25 decibel. So both conditions are fulfilled, so it is pure conductive hearing loss. Number two is sensorineural hearing loss. Isme do condition isme bhi fulfill honi chahiye. Number one is bone conduction and air conduction, both should be reduced, both should be below the level of 25 decibels. As you can see in the graph C, air conduction and bone conduction both are reduced, both are equally reduced, and there is no airborne gap, so it is pure sensorineural hearing loss. Number three is mixed hearing loss. In this, one condition of conductive hearing loss is present, and second one is of sensorineural hearing loss. First of all is both bone conduction and air conduction are reduced. We can see in the graph D, bone conduction and air conduction both are below the level of 25 decibels, and there is airborne gap. There is difference between both of these. So one component of conductive hearing loss is being fulfilled, which is airborne gap, and other one is of sensorineural hearing loss, which is both air conduction and bone conduction are reduced. So it is sensorineural, it is mixed hearing loss, neither pure conductive and nor pure sensorineural. Now we will look at these graphs one by one. First of all, graph A. सबसे पहले आपने 25 डेसिबल की लाइन को मार्क कर लेना है. ये जनरली ग्राफ के ऊपर ऐसे मार्क नहीं होती, ये अपनी आसानी के लिए बस आपने सबसे पहले इसको इंडिकेट कर लेना है. तो इससे पता चलेगा कि इससे ऊपर वाली जो भी रेंज होगी वो नॉर्मल होगी, और इससे नीचे वाली जो होगी वो एबनॉर्मल रेंज है. इससे पहले अब हम ग्राफ ए को देख रहे हैं. इसमें आपने सबसे पहले बोन कंडक्शन को देखना है. बोन कंडक्शन इज़ अबव द 25 डेसिबल रेंज, इट इज़ नॉर्मल. देन लुक एट द air conduction, it is also in above the 25 decibel range, both are in the normal range, so it is normal graph, it indicates normal hearing. Second one is graph B in the blue color. First of all, look at the bone conduction, which is in the normal range above the 25 decibel. Now look at the air conduction, which is in the abnormal range below the 25 decibel. So there is airborne gap. Whenever there is airborne gap, it indicates the conductive hearing loss component. And if other condition is also being fulfilled, which is the bone conduction is in the normal range, then it indicates it's a pure conductive hearing loss. Now coming towards the graph C, look at the bone conduction, which is below the 25 decibel range, and air conduction, which is also reduced, and there is no airborne gap, it indicates the sensorineural hearing loss. Coming towards the graph D, look at the bone conduction, which is reduced below the 25 decibel range, and air conduction is also reduced. It shows a sensorineural component, and there is airborne gap. Airborne gap indicates the conductive hearing loss. So one condition of conductive hearing loss and another one is of sensorineural hearing loss, it is the mixed hearing loss. The audiogram shows mixed hearing loss. So now we will look toward the another aspect of these audiograms. Type A shows the normal hearing of right ear, as bone conduction brackets facing towards the right side and air conduction is being shown by the circles. So graph A shows the normal hearing of right ear. Graph B shows the conductive hearing loss of left ear. Graph C showing the sensorineural hearing loss of right ear. And graph D showing the mixed hearing loss of left ear. I hope that you like the video. Thanks for watching.